फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। इन टूडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्पीक अबाउट द सन केतु कंजंक्शन विच इज गोइंग टू ऑकर इन द साइन ऑफ वृश्चिक और स्कॉर्पियो स्टार्टिंग 16th November 2021 टिल 16th December 2021। नाउ ऑन 16th November 2021 सन ट्रांजिट्स फ्रॉम द साइन ऑफ तुला और लिब्रा इन टू द साइन ऑफ Scorpio and he slowly starts moving towards Ketu, who is present in the Anuradha Nakshatra right now in transit. So you can see the planets Sun and Ketu represented by or bounded by a purple circle in this figure, and this is the chart as on 16th November 2021, and you can see Sun and Ketu present in the sign of Scorpio. Now first let us understand what is the sun. The sun is the universal soul. The sun also represents the universal father. The sun represents people in power, authority. Sun also represents name and fame. On a negative side, sun also represents our ego. What is Ketu on the other hand? Ketu on the other hand represents spirituality, represents isolation, represents liberation, represents moksha. Ketu represents moving away from material things and coming closer towards God or spirituality. So when the sun, that is the soul, comes in conjunction with Ketu, who is the significator of moksha or liberation, our soul experiences a strong desire to move away from material things and go closer to the final goal, that is God himself. Now what is the sign of Scorpio or Vrishik? The sign of Scorpio or Vrishik is the natural 8th house in the zodiac belt, and therefore it represents hidden things, buried things, secrets, occult knowledge and activities such as meditation, etc. Okay, so in this time period, the world is drawn towards isolation, towards spirituality, towards God, namely the activities represented by the 8th house. Therefore, it is a good time to meditate, to focus our mind on God and to develop intense love for God. On the negative side, the 8th house also represents misfortunes, fears, anxieties and accidents. And Ketu is very powerful in the 8th house of Scorpio. The sun represents our father. So in this time period, the health of the father may suffer in a big way. People in power may experience accidents, may experience challenges. Because sun also represents the government and the people in power and positions of authority. Ketu is also a headless being who does not care about the consequences. And when sun comes in conjunction with Ketu, it also represents our ego coming under the influence of Ketu. So Ketu can represent extremes. Either you will take extremely wrong decisions because of your ego, or your ego will be suppressed to such an extent that you would prefer to be isolated, you would prefer to move away to far off places located on high hilltops. You would prefer your own isolation. So this is also one impact of combination of Sun and Ketu in the sign of Scorpio. The sign of Scorpio represents hidden things, buried things, and Ketu represents depth. So if you are engaged in a research, Ketu gives you success in this time period. Also with the sun present there, sun throws light on all the activities represented by the 8th house. Therefore, secrets related to people in positions of power, certain classified government secrets, certain secrets related to the people in the film industry, all these things will come out in this time period. All these buried things, these hidden things will be exposed due to the light of the sun and the presence of Ketu there. Now Ketu will also give you some amount of pain, because to move closer to God, pain is often a medium, because until you don't experience pain, until you don't experience suffering, you do not wish to move closer to God. So Ketu gives us that pain deliberately by taking away the material things from us and moving us closer to God and making us know the real reality that nothing in this life is permanent. The sign of Scorpio also represents research and inventions. The sun represents our health. So during this time period when sun is conjunct with Ketu, Ketu supports research, and therefore new vaccines will come out in this time period with a better efficiency. With this background in our mind, let us now do an ascendant wise analysis and see how this conjunction affects every ascendant. So let us begin with the Aries ascendant or the Mesh Lagna. For the Mesh Lagna, the sun rules the fifth house of Leo. Now the sun has moved into the eighth house of Scorpio and is conjunct Ketu. Sun represents our health. Fifth house represents children. So during this time period, the health of children may be slightly problematic because the sun is conjunct Ketu in the eighth house. Also, if you are engaging in speculative trades, love affairs, etc., secrets related to those will come out in the open in this time period. There could be breaks in love affairs. Eighth house is also the house of misfortunes and accidents. Sun represents fire. Eighth house represents accidents. So when you are going out, be careful, as you might experience certain accidents related to fire in this time period. So for the Aries Lagna or the Mesh Ascendant, this is not a very good time. This transit is not very good for you. But again, because this conjunction is happening in your 8th house, if you are doing a PhD, if you are doing any kind of research, then this conjunction fosters success for you. Now for the Taurus Lagna or Vrishabh Ascendant, this conjunction is occurring in your 7th house of partnerships. So in your married life or in your business partnerships, there could be sudden anger issues, there could be sudden ego related issues, and Ketu also represents suppression. So if these ego issues or these anger issues exceed a certain boundary, the relationship might break, and this is what you need to be very careful about. Also, the sun rules your 4th house of Leo and has moved into your 7th house. So there will be lack of peace in the family or at home in this time period. You might feel the need to move away from home, to go to a far off place and live in isolation for some time. If that is what you are experiencing, then go ahead, live in isolation, meditate, and you will really find the peace of mind you are looking for. Let us now move to the Gemini Ascendant or the Mithun Lagna. So for the Gemini Ascendant, this conjunction is occurring in your 6th house of daily routine. Sun is also your 3rd house, indicating your courage, your valor, your short distance journeys, your neighbors. So in this time period, there will be some obstacles in your daily routine which might fluster you, which might confuse you and irritate you. So be aware of this and maintain your calm. You might also get into certain disputes with your neighbors because Ketu is present with Sun, and Sun is your 3rd lord, present in the 6th house of conflicts. So with your siblings, with your neighbors, conflicts can come up in this time period. Try serving small animals, try feeding sugar to red ants, worship Lord Ganesha, and this conjunction will not give you bad results. Let us now move to the Cancer Ascendant or the Kark Lagna, represented by the number 6 here in the chart shown. Now, for the Cancer Ascendant, Sun is your second lord, who rules your finances, who rules your family matters. And he has moved into the fifth house of past life good deeds, of knowledge, of children, of speculations. So in this time period, avoid investing in speculative activities such as stock trading, futures, options, etc. because you might suffer some loss because your second lord is conjunct Ketu, and Ketu will try to take you away from this material activity, thereby discouraging you from engaging in speculative trading. You might experience some amount of financial stress in this time period. This is definitely not a good time to take loans for you. So try conserving your finances. Try conserving money rather than becoming spendthrift in this time period. Because Ketu here can give you financial losses. He can also give you certain troubles within the family because Sun is your second lord. So sudden events, sudden problems to the health of family members can occur in this time period. And you need to be extremely careful on the financial front is the message which this transit gives you. Let us now move to the Leo ascendant or the Sima Lagna. So for the Leo ascendant, Sun is your ascendant lord, or he is the Lagnesh, and Sun has moved into the fourth house of Scorpio. Scorpio is the natural eighth house. Fourth house represents property, vehicles, happiness, peace of mind, sleep. So sudden issues related to property, sudden issues related to the health of your mother can crop up in this time period. So do not invest in property in this time period is the message for Leo ascendant. If you are driving vehicles, going on long distance journeys, those vehicles can experience certain breakdowns. Now, because Sun is your ascendant lord, he also represents your soul. And in this time period, your soul seeks isolation. So engage in activities such as meditation. Go to far off places such as hilltops, on isolated beaches, in isolated temples and monasteries, and you will find peace of mind there. If you cannot do that, simply engage in meditation, and that will also give you a lot of peace of mind. Let us now move to the Kanya Lagna or the Virgo ascendant. For Kanya Lagna, Sun rules your 12th house of isolation, of expenses, of bed pleasures, and he has moved into the third house of Scorpio. So now he is conjunct with Ketu in the sign of Scorpio. So the 12th lord has moved into the third house and is conjunct Ketu. So in this time period, you might feel a strong desire to move away to isolated places, to distant lands, to do some kind of soul searching. You might also encourage into certain activities where you may display an overdose of courage. Try to avoid that because Sun is with Ketu, and you might take some headless actions for which the consequences can be severe. Also avoid falling into unnecessary disputes with your neighbors and siblings. The health of your siblings could suffer in this time period. Let us now move to the Libra ascendant or the Tula Lagna. So for Tula Lagna, Sun rules your 11th house of gains, has gone into the second house of family matters, finances, which is actually good. But remember, Sun is conjunct with Ketu, and this is the natural 8th house in the zodiac belt. So the gains that you get, they will be sudden gains. However, this Sun-Ketu combination may force you to spend that money on spiritual activities, in charity, in helping others. And that is the message given to you by this conjunction. So for the Tula Lagna, whatever gains you get in this time period, spend it in helping others, in helping the poor, in doing charity. And this transit will give you good results. Now, because the 11th house represents friends, The second house represents your family, and Ketu represents isolation. In this time period, you might feel a desire to move to some distant places with your close friends. If that is the case, go ahead and do that, and you will find your peace of mind. Let us now move to the Vrishik Lagna or the Scorpio Ascendant. So for the Scorpio Ascendant, Sun rules your 10th house of career, business and profession. And this conjunction with Ketu is occurring in the first house itself. So in your workplace, there will be challenges. In your business setup, there could be challenges in this time period. But because Ketu represents spirituality, Sun represents the soul, and this conjunction is occurring in your first house, this is a very good time for engaging in meditation, in spiritual activities, because your soul is going to find its direction in this time period. Ketu and Sun here will encourage you to move towards the final destination or the goal for which we take birth as humans on this earth. So, a good time for spirituality, for meditation, but a bad time on the career front, on the business front for Scorpio Ascendant or Vrishik Lagna. Let us now move to the Dhanu Lagna or the Sagittarius Ascendant. So, for the Dhanu Lagna, this conjunction is occurring in your 12th house. Sun is also your 9th lord, representing your gurus, your teachers, spirituality and long distance journeys and pilgrimages. And he has moved into the 12th house, conjunct Ketu. So if you are moving to foreign lands, the conjunction of Sun with Ketu can bring certain obstacles, like your visas may get delayed, or in the travel itself, you might experience certain obstacles. To overcome that, you need to take the blessings of your gurus. Remember, the 12th house is the feet, and therefore taking the blessings of your gurus, touching their feet, will remove the bad effects of this conjunction. So the message for the Sagittarius Ascendant is to get in touch with their gurus, help them in any way possible, and take the blessings of their gurus. That gives you great growth, great prosperity, and protects you from the negative effects of this conjunction. Let us now move to the Capricorn Ascendant or Makar Lagna. So in the sign of Capricorn, you already have the Ascendant Lord Saturn and Jupiter present there. And on 20th November, Jupiter is moving into the sign of Aquarius, which is your second house. So it gives you a great growth in your finances. It also brings a lot of happiness in your family life. But now, where is this conjunction occurring? This conjunction of Sun and Ketu is occurring in your 11th house of hopes, wishes, aspirations, desires and friend circle. Therefore, in this period, you are going to get sudden gains because Sun is your 8th lord moving into the 11th house. So you are going to get sudden financial gains in this time period. But being the 8th lord moving into the 11th house, it is going to cause within you a feeling to move away from people, move away from things. And that is what your soul may desire in this time period. If you are engaged in a research activity, this transit or this conjunction of the Sun with Ketu is going to give you a lot of gains in this time period. Your close friends may experience sudden accidents or sudden misfortunes in this time period because the 8th Lord has gone into the 11th house and is conjunct Ketu. So this is one negative effect of this transit. Otherwise, this transit is good for you. It can also give you a sudden gain through inheritance. Let us now move to the Aquarius Ascendant or the Kumbh Lagna. So for the Kumbh Lagna, the Sun rules the 7th house of partnerships, and he has moved into the 10th house of your career, conjunct Ketu. So in your workplace, in your business partnerships, there could be sudden challenges. People in power in large organizations may suffer in this time period. especially the CEOs, the vice presidents, people in power in large organizations will suffer in this time period because Aquarius represents large organizations. You need to be careful when dealing with business partnerships, when dealing with your spouse, because this conjunction can bring about certain friction, certain issues in partnerships. Worship Lord Ganesha and the effects will be minimal for you. That is, the negative effects will be greatly reduced. Let us now move to the Meen Lagna or the Pisces Ascendant. So for the Pisces Ascendant, Sun rules your 6th house and he has entered into the 9th house and is conjunct Ketu. Now what is the 9th house? The 9th house is Gurus, Teachers, Pilgrimages. Being the natural 8th house, Scorpio represents occult activities. And when the 6th Lord has moved into the 9th house, this can cause certain conflicts with your Gurus, certain conflicts with your teachers in this time period. So try to avoid that consciously. Instead, take the blessings of your teachers, take the blessings of your Gurus, and that will help you in a big way. Try to visit temples and spiritual places. That is going to give you a lot of peace of mind. Engage in meditation, engage in activities such as yoga. That will also give you a lot of blessings in this time period. So friends, this is my short analysis of the Sun Ketu conjunction effect on every ascendant, starting from Aries to Pisces. Now if you do not wish to watch the whole video, I am providing timestamps in the description section as well as the comments section. You can simply press the timestamp and listen to that portion of the video. So friends, thanks a lot. If you have not subscribed to my channel Kamath Astrology, you can do so by clicking the subscribe button. For any consultations, you can book the consultations through our website astroseva.tripod.com, or you can email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. So friends, thanks a lot. Bye, take care, stay safe. We'll see you soon shortly with another video.